Oh, beautiful for spacious skies, for amber waves of May, for purple mountains, majesty above the fruited plain. America, America, God shed His grace on thee and crown thy good with brotherhood from sea to shining sea.
Since taking office, President Obama has made significant changes to America's policies in the war on terror. His agenda includes ordering the closure of Guantanamo Bay prison and outlawing torture of terrorism suspects. Next is reforming the CIA. Former Clinton Chief of Staff Leon Panetta will lead the change at the nation's top spy agency. But critics argue Panetta lacks intelligence experience and is too partisan for the position. Former Clinton advisor Dick Morris wrote recently that Panetta is as liberal as they come. He long ago embraced the left with the fervor of a convert and brings these values to the CIA. He added that choosing Panetta to head the CIA culminates liberals' 35-year crusade to take over the agency, humble its operatives, and rein in its operations.
Critics say the left's war against the CIA began in the 1970s. After Vietnam, secret assassination plots, and domestic spying, Democrats in Congress investigated the agency closely. They declared the need for openness over secrecy and dealing with unsavory intelligence contacts. Conservatives say these liberal attacks eventually gutted the agency.
But after 9/11, many Democrats began stressing the need for strong intelligence. And Republican Congressman Peter Hoekstra, who serves on the House Committee on Intelligence, says Panetta has the right background to lead the agency.
He was a member of Congress. He was a chairman of the Budget Committee. He was the chief of staff to the President of the United States, meaning that he has sat in on intel briefings. What I don't know, and what we'll monitor, and what we'll interact with Leon about, is what policies and what initiatives are you going to drive?
One job is to repair the CIA's image, which has taken a beating in recent years. The Bush administration used the agency's conclusion that Saddam Hussein possessed weapons of mass destruction as a major reason to go to war with Iraq. American forces there still haven't found any. There's also been questions on U.S. intelligence in key countries like Libya and Pakistan. Plus, the CIA helped complete a 2007 national intelligence estimate stating that Iran had given up its nuclear program. Panetta contradicted that report recently, saying that Iran is indeed still pursuing nuclear weapons.
That was quite possibly the worst intelligence estimate, anyway, the part of it that was made public, that I've ever seen or know anything about. It was extraordinarily misleading.
Hoekstra believes the Iran findings were part of a CIA campaign to undermine President Bush.
I think it's become very politicized. Almost every program that we put in place or that the Bush administration put in place to combat and conduct the war on terror leaked and became public. I think a lot of this stuff came out of the CIA.
Those leaks have raised questions about certain CIA tactics in the war on terror. President Obama has already banned one of them. Secret prisons for terrorism suspects. His position is unclear on rendition, the transferring of terror suspects from the U.S. to another country for interrogation. He has banned waterboarding.
One shouldn't go back and say, those of you CIA officers who followed orders and did waterboarding on Khalid Sheikh Mohammed, now you are criminals.
James Woolsey was CIA director under President Clinton.
What the CIA did, it did under the direction and authority and written authority of the President and the Justice Department, and I believe the interrogation procedures and so forth were briefed to at least the leadership of the congressional oversight committees.
Woolsey believes mind games and psychological tactics are more effective than physical torture, but that the CIA should be able to use techniques that some on the left have condemned.
Anybody asks the question, would you take the leader of the 9/11 attacks and play loud rock music until he said, just stop, 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 I'll tell you everything? you know, I'm comfortable with doing that.
Woolsey sees Pakistan, Iran, and North Korea as the agency's greatest challenges.
All of them, in one way or another, have nuclear weapons or potential availability of nuclear weapons.
Hoekstra says developing better human intelligence will be crucial for the CIA under Panetta's leadership.
There's only so much information that you can gather when you grab a secret that's being talked about on a cell phone. You're taking a picture from space. Those things only tell you so much information. You need a person sitting or around the table in the inner circle to give you the real insights as to what's going on with these people and these groups that may want to harm America.
One unresolved issue for the Obama administration is what it will do with the 245 prisoners still at Guantanamo Bay once the prison closes. There's also questions about how to interrogate terrorism suspects. The Obama administration has been adamant that it opposes torture, but not everyone agrees on what exactly crosses the line. Eric Stackelbeck, CBN News, Washington.